Hello everyone and welcome to my new doily paint video. Lately I've been to one of our local stores and I've seen that they were totally prepared for the Valentine's Day. And even though I don't really celebrate this holiday myself, from seeing all these hearts and flowers, all these things, I got really inspired to make something Valentine's special for my channel as well. I don't really want to make anything like Cupid doll, something very typical for Valentine, but I want to make very cute, very sweet, very dollish, a little bit old-fashioned marionette doll. And actually, we kinda can start working. The only thing I would really ask you to subscribe to my channel and to hit the bell button. Because just a couple of weeks ago, I had serious issues with my Aquarius video, because YouTube just didn't show it nowhere. You couldn't see it in your subscriptions. I couldn't see it myself on my own channel page. You could see it through search and you could get it as a notification if you already hit the bell button before. Of course, I needed to contact the YouTube support team. They fixed it in a couple of days. Yeah, they said it was some sort of a bug, but you know, I don't know what is gonna be the next time, so please hit the bell button because I'm really scared that it's gonna happen again and nobody will see my videos. And of course, yeah, they fixed it, but in these 3-4 days I've lost a lot of views and some people maybe even decided that I didn't upload that week. So that was the information, and now let's take all my supplies, choose the doll, and let's start the transformation. Let's go. For this look, I need a doll with a very childish and cute face, and I think Laguna Blue will be the best choice here. And at the beginning, let's do our preparation routine like always, take her outfit off, cut her hair as short as I can, and then I make her head soft with a hairdryer and take it off. Now I can remove the rest of the hair and all this nasty sticky glue from the inside of the head, and then I immediately give her new pretty and shining blonde saran hair. When the rerouting is done, I add tacky glue inside of the head and spread it there nicely to cover all the roots. Now I have to wait for sure for 24 hours or even more until the glue dries completely, so meanwhile I can start working on her body. And first of all I fill in the holes on her legs with clay, and then I'm also going to cut all the fins off. I've told you already in the beginning that I'm planning to make a marionette doll, the doll that will be controlled from above with a set of wires. And it means we need that extra high flexibility today. If you watched my last two videos, you know that I'm literally obsessed by this new technique. And if you're new to my videos, you will see now that I will remove all the extra plastic and vinyl around the joints, and like this I will win for sure plus 50% to their flexibility. After this, I sand the complete body with nail buffers to remove the glossy top, and then I take off all the grease with an acetone-free nail polish remover. Meanwhile, the glue seems completely dry, so I can remove the original makeup, protect her hair,
and then cover both the head and the body with white acrylic paint. When all the layers of white paint get dry, I cover them both with 3 layers of Mr. Super Clear sealant. While the sealant is drying, I'm preparing the pastels, and I want to keep her face very light with a touch of light blush, so I don't need lots of colors today. But first of all, I'm sketching her eyes and eyebrows. I want to give her very big dollish eyes and a very sweet and touching face expression. And when the eyes and the eyebrows are on their places, I can blush the face with the pastels we've just prepared. This layer I protect with Mr. Super Clear sealant, and then I can prepare the pencils and start drawing the face. First I work on the eyelids, giving them more realistic shading, and then I draw the eyebrows more detailed. The eyes will be very blue this time, and it also will be the main accent on her face. Then I draw the nostrils and the shadows around the nose, and I also add red to her lips, first with pencils and then with soft pastels. This layer I've protected with the sealant again, and now I will keep working on her eyes and add all the time more and more dimension to the way they look. After applying the shadows, it's time to draw the highlights with light pencils. Then I take a very sharp black pencil and draw the bottom lashes and the eye line. And I think I still want to add a little bit of yellow accents to the middle of the irises. It will make her eyes even more colorful and impressive. And then I add final reflections to her eyes with white acrylic paint. Okay, now it's time to blush her body with pastels, and then we can move on to the outfit and to the other details. First of all, I remove the protection from her hair and I peel off the sealant from the hair close to her face. It takes just a couple of minutes because dry Mr. Super Clear goes easily off. Then I take this hair curler that I always use on dolls and I give her a full head of beautiful curls. I let them cool down completely and then I fix them with a hairspray. Like this, her hair will for sure not become straight again. And then I style her hair in a very cute and romantic way. Now when the hair is done, I can glue the eyelashes and apply glossy varnish to her eyes and lips. Before making a bunch of matching accessories, let's first take a look at the dress made by my mom. I think it's one of her best works ever. Everything is just so detailed and so perfect. Then she also needs white panties, and the cherry on the top of this cake is this amazing frilled lace collar. Now I want to make for her a pair of ballet dancer shoes, and I've decided to try to make them with this epoxy sculpt. I've never tried it for making shoes before, but why not? I think it's gonna work, really, why not? If you can use even hot glue for this, then this epoxy sculpt is for sure stronger and better. And it's just very important to protect the doll's feet with tape, otherwise we will not be able to take the shoes off when they're dry. After 24 hours of drying, I cover the shoes with red acrylic paint, then with glossy acrylic varnish, and then I attach two ribbons to fix the shoes around the doll's ankles. Since it's Valentine's special, I want to make a bunch of hearts for decoration. And for this, I'm going to experiment today with my new resin. I've bought it a couple of weeks ago and I never had a chance yet to use it. So I mix the two components together and add some drops of very liquid red acrylic paint and mix everything together again. I'm going to work on this cutting mat because epoxy doesn't stick to it when it gets dry. So I'm making a bunch of different hearts, bigger and smaller ones. Let's see what I will get in the end. And I would like to have as a result a bunch of hairpins with hearts, a heart lollipop, and maybe some extra heart as a decoration. 24 hours later, I try to peel off the hearts from the mat and it goes pretty good. The hairpins I really like, I just want to trim the edges a little bit. The big lollipop also looks quite okay, but I think I want to make it a little bit smaller and also give it another stick. And finally, the biggest heart. It's of course a little bit challenging to get it out, but it also looks good in the end. And do you still remember that she's going to be a marionette doll? So let's now make the system to control her limbs. I take two popsicle sticks, make holes on the ends of them, and glue them together in a crossed position. Then I paint the cross with red acrylic paint, cover it with glossy varnish, and now let's build up some construction. First of all, I'm making a hole in the middle of this cross sticks, and it shouldn't come through on another side, just on the bottom of it. Now let's take a very standard doll holder, and you see there are lots of holes in it. I don't know why are they here? Probably made for people like me. So I install a barbecue stick into the middle hole and fix it there with hot glue. And another end of the stick I glue into the hole that we've just made with the Dremel. Then I paint the stick with black acrylic paint, and when the paint completely dry, I connect the hands and the feet of the doll with the cross popsicle sticks using pieces of very thin wire. And it's ready! I don't know, maybe I'm just too kind to myself, but this doll is absolutely one of my favorites ever. I think I should work some more with Laguna's dolls, because this face, it just looks so angelic. I think I still have a couple of them in stock for my future projects. And if this doll is not sold in Dubai, where I will be with workshop in the end of February, it will appear on my eBay page in the beginning of March. And if it doesn't sell on eBay, because I don't have that many followers there yet, I will sell her via my Etsy store. I get lots of questions about it, so this is how it's gonna happen in the near future. And also at the moment, I take no custom orders at all. I feel like I need to say it again, because sometimes I get too many messages about both, and I just cannot reply to all of them, I'm sorry. And now, please, let me know what do you think about this doll. I really want to know. And also please support this doll and my art with your likes, otherwise YouTube algorithm just doesn't know if it's interesting and if it can be recommended to other people or not. And also of course check if you're subscribed to my channel, hit the bell button to be sure that YouTube doesn't hide my new videos from you again. And welcome to the family if you're new here. I post new doll repaint videos every week Friday. And now let's enjoy the weekend. Have fun. Love you guys. Bye.